Let's move on to your one-woman show, Oh Miriam. Or I feel I should say, Oh Miriam.
Well, that's why it's called Oh Miriam, because all my life, people have said to me in different ways, Oh Miriam, Oh Miriam, Miriam, you know, that sort of thing. So it seemed a good title.
Who said it the most?
Oh, teachers at school, I think.
Really?
And sometimes girls I pleasured.
How did they say it?
I'm not going to do that now. This is a family show.
You are so delightfully naughty. So delightfully naughty that even the Queen told you off.
Yes. Her late Majesty, when I met her and she said, and what do you do? I said, I am the best reader of stories in the whole world. And of course she went and moved on. And the person next to me, she asked the same question. He was explaining. He said, I teach dyslexic children to read. And if the pages are in different colours and the letters are in different colours, helps the children to absorb the information more quickly and easily. And I, hearing this, standing next to him, I said, goodness, that's very interesting. I didn't know that. Really? And the Queen turned to me and said, be quiet. She was cross.
Do you think you've got saucier as you've aged? Have you always been a little bit naughty?
I've always been naughty. Mm. I just didn't do it on television. Mm. And nobody knew about it. And then when I got invited onto Graham Norton and chat shows and things like that, I just went on being the way I've always been. So, and I don't think I'm going to stop now because it's fun. I like shocking people. I like it when people recoil with distaste and a look of revulsion almost. I enjoy that.
Harry Potter fans versus Blackadder fans. If a Harry Potter fan was to yell out at you, what would they say compared to a Blackadder fan?
Well, a Blackadder fan always says wicked child, you know, say wicked child. Harry Potter, I worry about Harry Potter fans because they should be over that by now. You know, I mean, it was 25 years ago and it's for children. I think it's for children. But they get stuck in it. I do cameos and people say, oh, we're having a Harry Potter themed wedding. And I think, gosh, what's their first night of fun going to be? I can't even think about it. No. Harry Potter is wonderful. I'm very grateful to it. It's over. That's what I think.
So, the year ahead, what are you hoping to get out of this year? I know you've got mobility issues, but you've still got this one-woman show. I think that's amazing. You've got this one-woman show that you're taking all through Australia and New Zealand.
I don't know if I could call it one woman. It is me. I hope that I'm getting somebody to interview me, and then the audience can ask me questions. Oh. And I respond to what the audience asks. They put it on a little iPad, and probably the stage manager will tell me what they say. And that's what I like. I like connection. Connection with an audience. Connection with another human being. That, for me, is what keeps me going. I love to be part of the world. Part. And that's why I'm doing it. It's bloody lucky, isn't it? I'm amazed. Even if I have to be wheeled onto the stage, I can sit and talk to people.
Utterly uncensored.
Totally uncensored. Don't bring your children.